In this video, we will discover three features of the Algolia extension for Magento 2 that will help improve the search experience of your store: analytics, synonyms, and SKU reindexing. Please keep in mind that some of these features are only available for certain plans. To know exactly what you have access to, you can check out our pricing page on Algolia's website and scroll down to see the detailed list. Let's start with the analytics feature. In order to continuously improve the search experience of our users, we need to understand how and what they are searching on our store. That's why the extension provides three different types of analytics. First, there's Google Analytics that gives some basic search statistics. This will work only if you are already using Google Analytics on Magento. To enable it, move to Stores, Configuration, Algolia Search, Google Analytics. Set the first setting to Yes and save the configuration. You can then see the data in your Google account. The second type of analytics is Algolia Search Analytics. This will allow us to view detailed search statistics like popular queries, popular filters, queries with no results, and so on. It is enabled by default if it's included in your plan. To access all this information, log in into your Algolia account and click on the Analytics tab. Third, there's Algolia Click Analytics to get advanced search statistics, including the click-through rate and the conversion rate of each search. This is particularly useful to identify underperforming search queries and find ways to improve them. This feature is only available on higher-end plans. To enable it, click on the Click and Conversion Analytics tab, set the first setting to Yes, select what to count as a conversion, either clicking on the Add to Cart button or placing an order, and save the configuration. Then go back to Algolia's Analytics tab and there will be a lot of new data. A nice feature that you'll be able to leverage right from the extension panel is Synonyms Management. To access it, move to Stores, Configuration, Algolia Search, Synonyms. In some specific cases, it may be useful to have different search terms return identical results. For example, searching for T-shirt or tea should display the same products. For this to work, we need to create synonyms. Let's see how to do that. Set the setting Enable Synonyms to Yes. Click on the Add button. Type all the similar terms separated by commas. And finally, save the configuration. Now, typing T-shirt or T will show exactly the same clauses. This is called a two-way synonym. In some cases, we might want to create a one-way synonym. For example, someone searching for a tablet should see iPads in the results. However, someone looking for an iPad probably won't be interested in every kind of tablets available on the store. One-way synonyms are the way to go in this case. There are two important things to keep in mind. First, Algolia handles plurals and typos by default, so there's no need to create synonyms for that. Second, the number of synonyms you can create is limited and depends on which plan you are currently using. Next, let's talk about the reindex SKU feature that is in Stores, Reindex SKU. In some cases, products aren't indexed by Algolia, which means that you won't be able to find them in the search results. There are multiple reasons for this, for example, the product being disabled or out of stock. When that happens, it may be a little confusing. To understand what is going on, enter the SKUs of the problematic products and click on the Reindex button. Now, the extension will either update the products to fix the issue or explain why they can't be updated. Lastly, if we made any change to the Magento admin, we need to clear the cache by going to System, Cache Management, there selecting Configuration and Page, and clicking on the Submit button. In this video, we covered three features: analytics, synonyms, and SKU reindexing. They will all be useful to improve the search experience of your store. In the next video of this series, we will learn how to customize the Algolia extension with some coding.